I was really reluctant to cover Roswell in my film, The Phenomenon. Because,
I want to hear about this.
Because I was like, Roswell's kind of a hot potato. It's been there, it's been done, and people have been banging on about it. I was like, okay, well, if I'm going to cover it, what I did was I was looking into this incident called the Rockefeller Initiative. It was during the Clinton administration. And Lawrence Rockefeller at the time, billionaire, was putting significant pressure on the Clinton administration saying, you're going to open up the files for UFO files, or I'm going to expose the fact in every newspaper publication across the United States that you're not going to do that. Basically strong-armed the president. So the president basically was like, okay, what do you want me to look into? Is there a particular case? And Rockefeller said, yeah, how about Roswell? Because Roswell, I mean, if it happened.
Most popular.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And it's hardware. And it's beans, apparently.
Yep. Yep.
So the Clinton administration, believe it or not, went after Roswell and at the highest levels. And Podesta, on camera, told me, we were not happy with the answers we were getting. So they were making inquiries about it. So I covered Roswell because I'm like, I can't touch on Roswell in the film, assuming that I do penetrate a much broader audience, more mainstream audience. They're not going to know much more than the average Joe about Roswell. Let me just cover the core facts. And that is that the very people that were responsible for the deployment of atomic weapons, the 509th Bomb Squadron, announced to the world, this is all a fact, that they recovered a flying saucer. That's a fact. And it made headline news around the world like that, even back in 1947. Then they were taking the debris in a B-29 bomber, and they were flying it to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, Dayton, Ohio, which is where the Foreign Technology Division was, with a stop-off in Texas, Fort Worth. And when they got to Texas, get off the plane, there's a flurry of military activity and publicity with the media and everywhere. And the base guy looks at the people on the plane and they, keep your mouth shut, let me handle this. So he goes quiet and throws some debris from a Roswell weather balloon and says, terribly sorry, what we thought was a flying saucer turned out to be a weather balloon. Well, almost everybody in that press photo went on the record on camera before they died and said, the original story was true, it was not of this world, this is what we recovered.
When I was in high school, I was taking physics, and we had a lesson in pseudoscience one day. And he was going through different things that were definitely pseudoscience, you know. Alchemy was on the list. Maybe like 10 things, and one of them was the Roswell incident. And so my whole life,
wow.
You know, I grew up believing, because of what was taught to me in school, that this wasn't real. And you know, I'm not making a stand at this point in time, but I think it's fascinating how what you're told can resonate with you for so long, and then you open your eyes to something and realize none of it's true. Like, think about it. A high school teacher told me that this thing wasn't real, and I assumed, because he's the teacher, he's the authority, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I assumed it to be true, and it's almost just like I had to slap myself on my wrist and stop just accepting things that are told to me.